going to do a home tour and I'm going to show you what you can get in San Francisco for $7,000 a month. So it's pretty expensive, just like New York City. San Francisco, the real estate cost millions. We're not in the trendy downtown area. We're kind of like right smack dab in the middle. It's a little more family centered, but still super nice. So this is the dining room. We got the table from Amazon. We chose to go with the bench. And if you remember, this wall piece was in my methadone clinic when I was a drug and alcohol counselor. It's heard so many stories. It's seen the most hardened criminals cry. It probably has PTSD, but I assume it's pretty strong and he can handle it. If you hear my baby squealing in the background, he's 5 months, so you know, he likes to squeal. So we painted the space white. So the whole place used to be brown and had a bunch of random furniture, so we decided to repaint the whole place white. And I think it really opened it up and made it feel a little more fresh and modern. These are the landlord's drapes, the landlord's chandelier, and so we kept it because I thought it was kind of cool, kind of funky. This credenza and this credenza is from IKEA. This lamp is Kartell and I love it. It's like fine Italian design. I will link it below. I think I got it from Neiman's. I just put some various, this bucket usually goes in my bar cart, and this is my little crystal collection. We're replacing these two couches. And I got this from Amazon. And it's cute. It's kind of rickety, but I like how it combines the wood, the gold, and the marble. This bar cart I've had for a while, and I do entertain with it. These goblets are from the flea market, and they are real crystal. This is vintage. This is from West Elm. Other trinkets. I like how it has a mirror. Yeah, this bar cart's from Wayfair. My fiddle leaf fig tree. I'm not very good with plants. I'm surprised it has survived this long. So in this little bay window area, we plan on getting two Barcelona chairs. I already have them picked out. But for now, we use this rocking chair, which is really good because we put the baby to sleep easily by using that rocking chair. So if you can imagine this space with some two chairs and the replacement couches, I think it's going to look really beautiful. All right, so let me show you guys the bedroom real quickly. So again, yeah, we painted this whole hallway white. Here's a full bath. This is my son's bedroom. He's a teenager. This is my other son's bedroom. This is my bedroom. I'm not going to put anything on the walls. He's teething. Hey, I'm not going to put anything on the walls because I kind of like it fresh. This is my Ricky Tall. My bedroom's not all cleaned. My vanity. My closet with all my bags. I love it. And then it extends that way. These are my most used bags right here, my Balenciagas, which I love. So I'm gonna show you guys patina. I actually don't mind that, but I do plan on getting some half moon pulls to help the cabinets pull out. But yeah, I can't wait to get in this tub and have my candles. I love taking baths. I mean, I love taking baths. So I'm excited for that. Downstairs in my workshop. So mind you, there's a lot of boxes still that need to be unpacked. Okay, so this is the kitchen. The kitchen has a ton of counter space, a ton of cabinets. So much so that I forget what I put where. It's my little coffee station. I'm probably gonna get some decor for it, but we've only been here like 5 days. So downstairs, that's the laundry room where my husband does all the laundry. This is a full bath. My kids use. Probably messy, you know, kids. There's a lot of mirrors in this place. This is like a little half kitchen. My son Ryan's in there. This is the game room, which we haven't put anything yet. It's my daughter's room. We haven't decorated because we're waiting for a bunch of furniture to arrive. This is where I think I'm gonna put my dad. Nice spacious room. Good for an old man, an old man dingo. Yeah, so we got the comforter for my daughter. We still need a duvet cover. So I'm gonna show you where the magic is gonna happen, which is my workshop. Now, once we get rid of this truck, the space is gonna be a lot bigger, but looks like this. So you see, I got my MacBook, I mean my iMac, my printer, all my leathers here. I spent $1 million on this a long time ago, so I refuse to get rid of it. This is my die cutting station where I have all my custom dies so I can make perfect cuts. My packing station with packing boxes, my merch, my jewelry boxes. I have them in nude, navy, black, or pink. I designed these. My boxes, wrapping paper, my binder rings, which I mostly sell on Amazon. You can also purchase them on my website. My pegboard with my blades, scissors, needles, seam rippers, tapes, cutting mats, straps, glues, hot stamping machine. This is how I cut my edges of my leather. This is probably my most used bucket, my erasers, because if you have glue or something on leather or vinyl, you can use a white eraser, it'll come up. Sandpaper, more vinyls, more tools. I plan on covering more boxes. This is where I keep my little logo plates that I put on orders. This is my snap station. I have silver, rose gold, gold, all my threads. And this is my beast of burden right here, my console walking foot, so I can check on my orders in my little book and bust them out here, print my label. This table is really old, has a lot of dye on it from when I used to work with resin. But anyways, yeah, I'm really proud of my workshop and I hope to be able to get a lot of work done. So, only thing I need is a baby monitor so I can hear the baby when no one's home and I can hear if he wakes up. So, I want to thank everyone for watching and coming along with us on this journey. The next tour I do will probably be of my daughter's room when it's all dialed in, as well as our new living room setup. See you guys next time. Bye.